So a very, very warm welcome indeed to your Terrier Group judge, Mr. David Winsley. And the first of the best of breed Terriers is the Airedale Terrier, followed by the Australian Terrier, and the Bedlington Terrier, the Border Terrier, and the Bull Terrier, and the Miniature Bull Terrier, followed by the Cairn Terrier, and the Chesky Terrier, the Dandy Dinmont Terrier, and the Smooth Foxhair Terrier, the Wire-haired Fox Terrier, followed by the Irish Terrier, the Manchester Terrier, followed by the Norfolk Terrier, and the Norwich Terrier, the Parson Russell Terrier, the Scottish Terrier, the Sealion Terrier, the Skye Terrier, the Soft-Coated Wheaton Terrier, the Staffordshire Bull Terrier, the Welsh Terrier, and the West Highland White Terrier. So, as the dogs move into place, David's going to have his first look at this group. There were 958 terriers entered here today. Terriers, as a group of dogs, have always played a significant part in our social history. And through the centuries, these breeds have often been portrayed by painters and writers alike. Often being portrayed as feisty with very big characters, dogs which sometimes require a firm hand, this is a wonderfully tenacious group of terriers. Not only extremely loyal companions, but incredibly affectionate and important family members in many households across the world. So, the first of the terriers in this terrier group at Windsor is the Airedale Terrier, judged today by Ronnie Irvin, and Ronnie selected the male, number 3, as his best of breed winner. This is the largest of the terriers, originating in the valleys of Ayr and Wharfedale in Yorkshire. This king of the terriers was once known as the Waterside or the Bingley Terrier. As far back as 1884, the famous dog Keith Lee Crack won the Kennel Club show. Their separate classification in the stud book came 2 years later in 1886. So the first of the best of breed winning series, this is the Airedale, number 3. Don't be afraid to applaud. Let's hear some applause, please, for this first of this exciting group of terriers, the Airedale. First of the dogs on the table is the Australian Terrier. Tim Ball was our judge today of the Australians. Tim selected a female, number 44. That's number 44, the best of breed winning Australian Terrier. As the name of this terrier suggests, the breed is a native of Australia. It in fact can be traced back to some of the Scottish and North of England Terrier breeds introduced by settlers into Australia in the 19th century. Derived from a cross of the Cairn, Yorkshire and the ETT, although this is still very much in debate. The best of breed winning Australian Terrier, the female number 44. Thank you. On the table now, we see the Bedlington Terrier. Sharon Ames was our judge today of the Bedlingtons. And Sharon selected this male, number 88, to represent the Bedlingtons in the group this evening. Once known as the Rothbury Terrier, or the Northumberland Fox Terrier, the earliest mention of the breeds around the beginning of the 18th century. The name Bedlington Terrier not being taken up until the 19th century, first being classified as a breed in 1870, where there was an impressive 52 entries at their very first show. The wonderful lamb-like look of this dog is deceptive, because believe me, the Bedlington is a terrier through and through, as tough as nails, brave and courageous. Number 88, the Bedlington Terrier. This is now an urgent call for Mrs. M. Dauphin Simmons. Your dog is in distress. We have a vet at your car. Can you please return to your car immediately? Mrs. M. Dauphin Simmons. Border Terriers today were judged by Michael Hollingsby. It's the bitch, number 181, that David's examining on the table now. Number 181. The best of breed winning Border Terrier. The origins of this breed can be linked to the borders between England and Scotland, Westmorland and Northumberland, and date back to the late 18th century. This is a multitasker. Small fox terrier must be capable of following a fox to ground, but should have the stamina and length of leg to follow the field of horses on a day's hunting in the rugged country of the border district. That's 181, the Border Terrier. Bull Terriers today were judged by Mark Phillips. He selected this female, number 217, as best of breed winner. In the 1930s, there was a huge burst of interest in the popularity of the Bull Terrier. Indeed, at the Great Joint Terrier Show at Olympia in 1931, Bull Terriers delighted their own friends and dumbfounded the supporters of hitherto more popular breeds, by achieving the largest single entry in the show, a staggering 223. Here we see a white Bull Terrier. The first coloured Bull Terrier champion was a brindle and white champion bitch called Lady Winifred, winning her third and qualifying CC at Crufts in 1931. The best of breed winning Bull Terrier, number 217. So it's good to see the miniature Bull Terrier with classification here again at Windsor. Judged today by Ken Bartlett, this is a female, number 259. Also originating in the 19th century, this handy-sized dog makes an excellent watchdog, an ideal companion in the home. Full of life and vitality, as you can see in front of you. Lovely dark patches on a white body. Hard to mistake. This one, a smaller version of the previous dog with a height restriction of 14 inches or 35.5 centimeters. The best of breed winning miniature Bull Terrier, number 259. the miniature Bull Terrier Best of Breed winner. On the table now we see the Cairn Terrier. Francis Goldfinch was our judge. This is a male, a 3-2-3. Scottish in ancestry, it's believed that the Cairn can be traced back over 500 years to the period in history of Mary, Queen of Scots, and to the island of Skye. It's first recognised as a separate breed in 1910. Its development runs side by side with those other Scottish breeds, which we'll see later in the group, the West Highland White, the Scottish Terrier, and the Skye Terrier. The best of breed winning Cairn Terrier number 3-2-3. Mark Kokoza was the judge of the Chesky Terriers today. Mark selected this male, number 342, as his best of breed winner. It's the national dog of the Czech Republic. Originating in the late 1940s, in the 1950s, the breed was produced by mating the Scottish Terrier with a Celium by a Czech, Franciek Horak. First arrived in the UK in 1989, registered in 1990. Gaining rare breed status from the Kennel Club in the millennium year, with challenge certificates to follow very soon. The best of breed winning Chesky Terrier 3-4-2. Kathy Green was the judge of the Dandy Dinmont Terriers. This is a female, number 385. Quite an old breed here, having been developed in the 17th century. Despite being a renowned otter and badger hunter and quite a digger, the Dandy can quite easily melt your heart, literally in an instant, with its soulful expression, and just look at that on the table now. Dandy Dinmont was in fact a name given by Sir Walter Scott to the gentry farmer James Davidson of the Borders, who bred a hard-bitten, courageous terrier. It was these that Scott described as Dandy Dinmont dogs. First breed club was started in 1875 in Selkirk on the Borders. The breed comes in two colour varieties, mustard and pepper. This is a pepper. The best of breed winning Dandy Dinmont 385. On the table now we see the Smooth Fox Terrier, judged by Mandy Saunders. This is a bitch, number 431. It's another 19th century breed originating in the British Isles when it was called the Gentleman of the Terrier World. Originally used for locating the position of foxes in their lairs and in dealing with vermin, this digging trait is strong in the breed today. first breed standard was laid down in 1876, some 4 years after the Fox Terrier Club had been formed. The smooth Fox Terrier, number 431. Wire Fox Terriers today were judged by Max King. This is a male, 451. And some interesting facts here. Curled up at his master's feet forever in St. George's Chapel, Windsor, is a marble wire-haired Fox Terrier, part of the effigy of the tomb of King Edward VII and Queen Alexandra. So if you get a free moment, you can go and look at that up at the castle in Windsor Chapel. The Wire Fox Terrier, immortalised as Caesar, was a gift in 1902 from the Duchess of Newcastle. In the 1930s, it was the Wirehead Fox Terrier that headed the list of terrier registrations at the Kennel Club for many, many years. Another digger, especially in the garden, enjoy lots of exercise. The best of breed winning Wirehead Fox Terrier, number 451. The judge of the Irish Terriers. Sue selected this male, number 483. From the Emerald Isle, bred for their sporting attributes, by instinct, thorough and effective at dispatching vermin, excelling at rabbiting, badger facing, fox facing, otter facing, and is just as good in the water too. This breed's first entry into the Kennel Club stud book was 1876. Number 483, the Irish Terrier Best of Breed. Ken Bartlett was the judge of Manchester Terriers today. It's his second breed. He selected this male, number 534. In the 1870s, the breed was one of the most popular entries in the Kennel Club stud book. It wasn't until the 1990s that the actual name of the Manchester Terrier appears. Possible reason for this is largely because of the quantity of black and tan terriers that could be found in the cotton industry, which at that time centred on Manchester indeed and the environs around. The Manchester Terrier, number 534. Howard was the judge of Norfolk Terriers, and this is a bitch, number 584. I'm losing my paperwork here, apologise for that. Number 584, the best of breed winning Norfolk Terrier. As the name suggests, this breed originates from the county of Norfolk and indeed the fens of East Anglia were the birthplace of the Norfolk Terrier. During the 19th century, the breed was popular with farming and sporting communities in controlling vermin, especially in the grain stores where they were very effective. Number 584, the best of breed winning Norfolk Terrier. On the table now we see the Norwich Terrier. Eileen Needham was our judge, and this is the male, number 615. Obviously another breed connected with East Anglia. The Norwich in its working life was used not only on fox and badger, but on rats as well. Until 1932, the breed was little known. It was this year that saw the Norwich enter the Kennel Club register when Mrs. Normandy Rodwell called a meeting of all available Norwich Terrier breeders at the Richmond Championship Dog Show in July 1932. And hence the Norwich Terrier Club was formed. Typically bossy little terrier with a big heart. Note his pricked up ears, which differentiate the breed from the previously seen Norfolk. Best of breed winning Norwich Terrier number 615. Parson Russell's also judged by Max King, had a busy day. He selected this female, number 669. Smooth or rough-coated, this breed is a real type of Jack Russell Terrier kept by the Reverend John Russell from Dartmouth in Devon in the 1820s and 30s. The Parson Russell Terrier, number 669, excuse me. On the table now we see the Scottish Terrier, another breed judged by Ronnie Irving. This time it's a bitch, number 716. Scottish Terriers, originally known as the Aberdeen Terrier. The Kennel Club decreed that the Scottish Terrier be its proper name in 1890. The Earl of Dumbarton nicknamed this dog the Little Diehard. Full of personality they are too. The best of breed win is Scottish Terrier number 716. And Bradley was the judge of senior terriers today. This is a male, number 745. Originating from the estate of Celium at the very tip of South Wales, it was Captain John Tucker Edwards who established the breed in 1848. It had to be low to ground and strongly made to deal with fox and badger. First Celium Club was formed in 1908, recognised 1911 by the Kennel Club some 3 years later. Surge of interest for this breed, the end of the First World War. Famous owners of this breed include Hitchcock, Betty Davis, and Elizabeth Taylor, just to name a few. Best of breed winning senior. Sarah Downs was the judge of the skies today. This is a female, number 757. Breed, as you can see, has to be long and low, comes with brick ears or the less common drop ears. And indeed, in years past, the breed was actually divided into these two different varieties, with four sets of CCs available to each show. Here we see the more common prick ears on the Skye Terrier. Another interesting historical fact is that Queen Victoria owned the breed from 1840. In 1902, at the Manchester Championship Show, there were an unbelievable 102 entries in Skye classes. Seven, the Skye Terrier. We move on to the soft-coated Wheaton Terrier. Excuse my cough, ladies and gentlemen. Philippa Pearson was our judge. This is the male, number 766. First recognised by the Irish Kennel Club in 1937, and by the UK Kennel Club some 6 years later. Wheatons were originally used for herding and guarding livestock, and also for controlling vermin. Originally an all-purpose farm dog in Southern Ireland, this is the best of breed winning soft-coated Wheaton, number 766. John Ryden is the judge of the Staffordshire Bull Terriers. This is a male, number 891. the name. It suggests the breed originates from Staffordshire, traces its ancestry to crosses of bulldogs and local terriers. Staffords, as they are known, were first recognised by the Kennel Club in 1935. CC status followed 3 years later in 1938, before the Second World War. Renowned for its courageous yet friendly nature, this is an extremely powerful breed, increasingly popular in many households worldwide. Numerically, the highest entry here today in the Terrier Group. The Staffordshire Bull Terrier. Another breed judged by Ken Bartlett, the Welsh Terrier. This is a male number 910. This breed's history dates back a few hundred years. Established in the mountains and valleys of Wales, the purpose of this breed, like so many of the other terriers, was to go to ground after game or quarry. Rodents, fox and badger. First exhibited in 1886, same year that the Welsh Terrier Club was formed. They were also recognised by the Kennel Club in the same year. The best of breed winning Welsh Terrier number 910. Windsor 2015 is the West Highland White Terrier, judged today by Nicola Foster. This is a male, number 932. A family favourite, the Westie, as it's known, is another Scottish breed established in the 19th century, first being given its current name in the early 1900s. Was Edward Donald Malcolm, 16th Laird of Portalloch, who's most closely associated with developing the modern breed. West Highland White Terrier, best of breed, number 932. So that concludes the individual examination of the second group of Windsor 2015. 23 of the breeds present for David to look at. He's going to look at them all one more time. We've got 13 dogs to come through, 10 bitches. Representing just under 10% of the total entry for Windsor this year. It's lovely to see David giving each one of these dogs an individual second examination before he makes his shortlist. So the first of the shortlisted dogs is going to be the Bedlington. Look, the Bull Terrier. And the Cairn Terrier. The Dandy Dimwont. The Wyre-haired Fox Terrier. The Norfolk Terrier. The Scottish Terrier. And the Welsh Terrier. That concludes David's shortlist. Many thanks to those other best of breed winners. Congratulations on winning through to the group. Do travel safely home, and we look forward to seeing you here next year. So as these shortlisted dogs, eight of them, move round, you can put your hands together, please, ladies and gentlemen, who have made the shortlist. Just going to move them one more time, straight up and down. And then I think he may well ask them to go round, as we saw in the utility group, round to join on at the end. So this is your chance. The Bedlington Terrier, best of breed, the male, number 88. Sent through to us by Sharon Ames, the best of breed winning Bedlington Terrier. Now it's the turn of the Bull Terrier. This is the bitch number 217. Sent through by Mark Phillips, the best of breed winning Bull Terrier, the bitch number 217. The Cairn Terrier, number 323. Selection of Francis Goldfinch, this is the Cairn Terrier, 323. Three, 385, the Dandy Dimmock Terrier. Kathy Green was our judge of Dandy Dimmocks today. 385 for Dandy Dimmock, best of breed. Now this is Max King's selection in the Wyre-haired Fox Terriers. Number 451. The best of breed winning Wyre-haired Fox Terrier. This is the Norfolk Terrier. Number 584. Selection of Cherry Howard, 584, the Norfolk Terrier, best of breed. Ronnie Irvin sent us the Scottish Terrier through. This is a bitch number 716. The Scottish Terrier. Now it's the turn of the Welsh Terrier, number 910. Set through by Ken Bartlett, completing the 8 shortlisted dogs in the Terrier Group Windsor 2015. Nine-one-zero, the Welsh Terrier. So, David, to move them all one more time. One last look as we get the boards into place, please. So, as the boards come into place, David takes that final look. Very soon we will know who the second finalist will be for Sunday's grand finale. So, the winner of the Terrier Group Windsor 2015 is the Bedlington Terrier. Runner-up, second in the group. It's the Scottish Terrier. Third in the Terrier group goes to the wire-haired Fox Terrier. And fourth in the group. It's the Norfolk Terrier. Congratulations to those other four shortlisted terriers. Well done. Huge congratulations to our winner, the Bedlington Terrier. And a big round of applause for our judge, David Winsley. If I could now ask for the Bedlington Terrier, the winner of the Terrier Group, followed by the Scottish Terrier, the Wirehead Fox Terrier, and the Norfolk Terrier. Well done.